Alice is a stay-at-home mother of four, struggling with the decision to reveal a shocking secret to her friend Shannon. She fears that revealing this will end their friendship. And she's also set this up to help you understand that if this does end the friendship, it'd be very shattering to her.
Okay.
So, are you prepared to hear what she has to say?
Yes.
You prepared to say it?
Yes.
Okay. Alice, you're on.
When I was in high school, I was friends with several people. I had a boyfriend that abused me extremely bad. Well, there was supposed to be a fight and he was supposed to get beat up. He ultimately got murdered right in front of me. Everybody went to prison. I went for 8 years on a 40-year prison sentence.
Okay. Did you have anything to do with him being murdered, or it was just because you were there?
The majority because I was there to watch a fight and it turned into a murder.
Let's be a little clearer, Alice.
Because of the abuse I had suffered from him.
Physically?
Yes.
Okay.
The boys were supposed to beat him up, and it turned into more than just beating him
up. Did you hire the boys to have them beat
him? No. One was his best friend of 15 years. There was actually more to that that I didn't even know of happened between the two of them until after I was arrested, to why they did what they did. But that ultimately had nothing to do with me, that part.
There are two parts, I think, that are important, though. You helped get him to that location.
Yes.
Let's be fair.
Yes.
You got him there.
Yes, I've always taken that responsibility.
People would say you lured him there.
I've always been there, yes.
And then once it happened, then she was threatened with her life if she were to say anything to anybody. And you should also own the piece where you were the one that did speak up.
Yes, I did. I'm the one that went to the police and basically got the whole investigation rolling.
After he was murdered.
So it was messy, complicated. And with the trauma history and all, you kind of know how those things happen. Mm-hmm. Shannon, I see you struggling, trying to get your head around it. What are you feeling?
I feel that if it was, I was abused in high school physically from a boyfriend for a couple years, but I finally left and just got out. I don't understand why she would actually want people to come to beat him up. I would just have left, or I would have went to the police, got a restraining order, or I would have literally went across the United States to get away from him, Canada, I don't know. If you were that worried, or if they said they're going to kill, if you say anything, they're going to kill you, I would have left. Before the action. After the action, I don't understand how somebody could just stand there and watch and not call 911 as you see a baseball come out. That would be my first reaction. Even though you probably hated him and you wanted him to die in your heart or your head, I can't understand why you would just sit there and...
Well, it was out in the wilderness. There was no cell phones at the time either. And it was at a wilderness lake area. It was totally undeveloped. And as far as apart from when it happened, I was in it because I had heard from my friend that her boyfriend was basically fed up with his bullying and abuse and the stuff that they were doing together, and he just couldn't take it anymore, so he was going to fight him. And I figured after what he put me through, I'd like to see him get his butt beat after being through it, so that's why I was there.
Was he still your boyfriend?
No.
Oh, so you had already broke up? And
yes,
you knew.
We had already broken up.
Okay. I did not expect you to say that. But I still stand by you. I know you as a person.
Thank you.
I won't leave.